Thanks for joining us at News-Sentinel.com. I'm Tom Davis, sports editor with the News-Sentinel, and I'm joined by sports reporter Justin Kinney. And Justin, we just watched Notre Dame open their season with a really impressive, nice 48-17 win over Rice. Let's start off offensively. What are a couple of things that really jumped out at you that, hey, the Irish looked good? Even though it was opening week, they did this well.
Really impressed with Everett Golson. His decision-making, when to run, when not to run, get out of the pocket, extend plays. I mean, he was dynamic at times in 2012, but he also had those mistakes that you expect out of a young player. And for one game at least, he really cleaned those up.
Now, what was really surprising to me was there was only a couple of penalties.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if they had a turnover. I don't think
No turnovers. Two penalties, no turnovers. A very clean game for a week one game.
Yeah, and very clean for Notre Dame, period.
Definitely.
We've seen Notre Dame shoot themselves in the foot, and I wonder if this is just a maturation process of the program. What is it, year five with Brian Kelly? So maybe everything that he's been preaching, guys have heard it for 3-4 years, and it's just an evolution of the program.
Well, it could be. It could be the opponent, not to take anything away from Rice. A 10-win team a year ago, but it's not a Michigan that you're going to face week two. It's not a Stanford. So, if it continues as a trend, week 3, 4, 5, then we're on to something. But for week one, I think maybe a little bit too soon to say Notre Dame has really cleaned up making mistakes.
Now, it's safe to say that coming into this game, I think we're both pretty confident offensively in this team, but defensively, especially with the suspensions, we had a lot of question marks. I thought they did okay, and I understand it's Rice, but there were no really glaring weaknesses defensively.
Yeah, with Austin Collinsworth out for the foreseeable future, that's five guys on their team deep that are out either due to the academic probe or injury. And for one game, at least, they held up pretty well. Some dicey moments.
And a really surprising part of the defense, Carroll High School graduate Drew Tranquil. He's in on a lot of plays. Now, Brian Kelly had said during camp he'll be in on special teams. He was in the rotation at safety, brought him down playing him in the front seven some. I mean, he was all over the place.
Yeah, we were kind of surprised to see him so early. Lining up at the middle linebacker position a couple times and some heavy sets on third down, obvious passing downs, moving outside, doing some edge rushing. I mean, he was all over the place. So it was a good first game. Got plenty of action on special teams as well. So for a first game for a freshman, Drew Tranquil performed pretty well.
All right, so Notre Dame fans are really pumped up because their team looked really good today. Michigan fans are really pumped up because they didn't actually lose to Appalachian State this time. They did what they were supposed to and blew them out. So a lot of hype going into next week's game when Michigan comes to Notre Dame Stadium, as Justin and I are standing here right in the end zone. Justin, Michigan coming in. You feel confident in Notre Dame, or have you been burned so many times by Notre Dame in Michigan games?
I think it's a toss-up rivalry. You know, anything can happen. Devin Gardner last year just tore up Notre Dame's defense. After that game, he started having some nagging injuries and kind of leveled off and kind of get progressively worse. So Michigan was at their best last year playing Notre Dame and beat Fighting Irish up in Ann Arbor. This time Michigan comes in. A big game for both teams, I think especially Brady Hoke. Michigan Wolverines. You know, they need a big year. Brady Hoke needs a big year.
Yes, he does.
And this is their first big test. Go on the road in prime time to try to knock off a nationally ranked opponent, Notre Dame. So it's going to be huge.
I think it's going to be really difficult for Michigan defensively to slow this Irish offense down enough, especially here in South Bend. So I feel pretty good about Notre Dame next week. But we'll see. That's why they play the game. Thanks for joining us at News Center.